It was all a dream on the scene, making memes.
Then I came along and changed everything.
From ciphers to diapers.
Green jiggly things.
But the grind don't stop.
We just got a bigger team.
Hard to wait to the top.
Mom, what does that mean?
The time is now or never. We are dream team.
I was gonna get paid for this.
What's up, guys? It's your girl, Lyric Kane, aka Nini, aka whatever it is that you want to call me. Back with yet another reaction video. What? Baby Kane over there tearing out toys. After I asked her not to. But we're back with yet another reaction video. Oh, she's putting Barbie on her clothes. As requested in the comment section underneath one of my other videos, today I'm going to be reacting to MGK All Night Long. The last video I checked out by him definitely put me in a very vulnerable situation, a very vulnerable position, and I low-key lost my cool. I want to apologize. I ain't no punk, and crying ain't something I do on the normal, so, like, don't get it twisted. Yeah. Here she comes, Dr. Phil. You come tell them something, baby cakes.
Sometimes I get air sick.
Oh.
On my tummy. Because I did.
Yeah, of course. Totally. Totally, bub. But, yeah, you already know the original video link will be in the description box down below. As well as all of my social media links. Make sure that you follow us on IG. Best friends since birth. Also, check out my music page on IG. Lyric Kane Official. Also in the description box down below, you'll be able to find my other YouTube channel. Make sure that you head over there and check out my music. If you like what you hear, then go ahead and give the video a thumbs up. Subscribe and turn on notifications so that you don't miss out on all of my latest music videos, original songs, cover songs, remakes, remixes, challenges, and live performances. I got my pen and my paper, and you already know what it is. I'm going to go ahead and adjust the volume. Let's get right into the video. And I'm not sure if this is just audio or video or both or... I think a video. Who wins?
Hey yo, this that shit you bob your head to. This that brand new instrumental. I heard he put his city on. That boy Kel so influential. Success got everybody hating. Success to me is inspiration. Cause how we supposed to know that what we dream is possible if don't nobody that looks like us makes it? You only got one life, don't waste it. I mean, we only got one night, get wasted. I mean, I know you trying to think it out, but go with what you feel, cause real problems can't be calculated. It's hard to find the answers when they have no explanation. It's hard to find where you're headed when there's no destination. It's hard to know when we're going when there's no expiration. So until that day, just keep that Kells inside your playlist, then. Drinking whiskey like a desperado. My bitch is drinking reposado. Ashing in an empty bottle. Listening to the sounds that put our asses in this empty condo. Remember ride around in Ashley's car though. When the radio first played our song though. Or at her house when MTV first showed my face. That clip was crazy. I swear it felt like we won the lotto. But a million bucks can't buy priceless moments. And a million people may not know us, but every one of them wants this gift we own. How to keep it real, how to never judge somebody by the steering wheel. Cause you know that motherfucker in that Ford Taurus could be the next motherfucker in that new Porsche. But like I said, it's hard to know where you headed when there's no destination. So until that day, just keep that Kells inside your playlist, then.
I always wanted to do that, strangely enough. I don't even play the guitar. I just want to smash one, though. Directed by Maud Sun. So was this directed by, there was another video I can't think of the name of right now, by MGK that I got to check out thanks to you guys. And it was, I told you guys it gave me like school play type feels, and it was low-key set up like this where he was just kind of traveling through scenes and there was just like, cats like crying. But there was like makeshift type of sets and props all around him. But was that directed by the same person? Because this one low-key gave me the same feels. I thought it was pretty dope. My favorite part was when he went by certain things and they were like in the picture frame. I literally thought, especially the one where the dudes were like on the piano with all the different colors, I literally thought that was a picture to dudes' heads start like bobbing. So that right there was definitely dope. Visually, I felt like this right here was just... But that's something I'm starting to low-key expect from his videos, which I'm really happy for. I love the cinematic and the creativity that you're able to see through it. Like, it's cool to have simple videos, but it's also cool to have those videos that you can tell somebody put some thought into, some innovation into it. You know what I mean? Motivate us to stay on our toes and, you know, mix it up sometimes. Sometimes it's cool to step outside of your comfort zone. He said a line in here that I thought was pretty dope. Of course, he dropped killer lines in here left and right, but there's just a few that I thought was pretty dope. He mentioned real problems can't be calculated. For those who, that went right over your head. Saying, like, you know how in school they're always teaching you to solve problems, like, you know, on calculators, like this type of math, that type of math. Real problems, like day-to-day problems, the struggle, things of that nature, can't be calculated. So you definitely got, I mean, you want to live each day as if it's your last. But at the same time, you want to have like a balance of realizing you need to have ideas and start planning for your tomorrows, if that makes any type of sense. Find your balance. Like, definitely live for the moment, but don't live so much for the moment where you just splurge and then you don't have shit for tomorrow. Like, bro, come on. Come on now. The first TV moment, I like the part where he mentioned that, the first time he remembers seeing himself on TV, how they were just like super duper ecstatic. I can definitely... imagine how crazy that feeling could have been. I have actually been doing a bit of acting myself for quite some time. So I have seen myself on TV, but it wasn't necessarily, I haven't been on TV yet for music. Let's put it that way. And I haven't had a leading role. It was always a supporting role or a feature. So that right there would definitely be dope. I can only imagine what's going to take place when I do see myself on TV. My daughter had a TV moment. She was in FX new show Snowfall. I think it was the very first episode. She was also in here recently they showed it, an episode of Deadly Sins, which comes out on the ID channel. She was in... I can't think of the name of it, but the one where the police cadet, she was killed by her lover, and she played the daughter of the young lady who was murdered, and they like went back and kind of like reenacted it. And it was crazy because we see her clip in Snowfall. They used the clip of her like crying or whatever, which was what the clip was supposed to be. They needed her to cry, but I guess she didn't get that, so she cried in real life, and she was like, "Why did they show me crying on TV?" And I'm like, "Cause obviously you're a crybaby. You're crying right here." She probably gets it from me though. Who am I to talk? But that right there was definitely hilarious. But I remember seeing the other part where she saw on Deadly Sins, and she totally like flipped out. Like she was like, "That's me, Mom. That's me." And I'm like, "I know. No shit, Sherlock. I took you." But yes, those are definitely defining moments, moments that you're super proud of. If you follow us on IG, either Lyric Kane Official or Best Friend Since Birth, I was all on there with proud mommy moments, like my baby. I raised her so well. It's just really a touching feeling to know that something I started for her at such a young age. For those who don't know, my daughter started acting at 15 days old. Yes, I went and signed her up. Acting has always been a passion of mine. That's something I want to share with her. And I love the aspect of the Coogan account where they set a certain amount of funds aside until they're 18. So I am building that college fund. And I've always told myself in the back of my head, like whenever she decides she no longer wants to do it, we'll walk away. But by the graces of God, she's actually enjoying it. She's and loving every step, which is just bringing me to tears. I'm like, my baby actually loves to do what I do. It's just weird, though. Another dope line that he mentioned up in here. Like I said, it's full of a ton of them. But he said the dude in the four-door next week could be, like, basically the millionaire. Like, you never know. Like, you just... you just never know who you're talking to. I always think about the time I walked into a bank one time. So I'm getting ready to walk into this bank, and this Asian guy pulls up. True story, all right? Real facts. This Asian guy rolls up to the bank, and he's on this bike, like this makeshift bike, some shit I could have seen like in Jamaica or maybe like a third world country somewhere. There's no handlebar. There's like a piece of stick that's stuck through there for the handlebar, like a broom handle maybe. There was also something similar down below for the pedals. The wheels and the tires were just real ate up. Dude had on these sandals. I call them Jesus sandals. But he had on these sandals that look like his whole appearance just caught me off guard. And to be honest, and I know it's horrible, but it's just something we do as human nature. Like we kind of categorize people instantly without verbally saying it. It's just something that we do. And to be honest, when he first approached me, and because he approached me outside to open the door, he actually opened the door for me. And I was like, oh, thank you. You know what I mean? And to be honest, I thought he was going to ask me for a dollar. And I know that probably makes me such a horrible person, but it was just literally my first thought. So when he held the door open for me, I was like, oh, thank you. And I noticed he came in behind me. And I was like, oh, my bad. Like, he's actually coming in. Long story short, so I'm sitting there chilling at my register talking to the person about my negative funds. Right? Now, mind you, I just rolled up. And at the time, I think I was driving a Cadillac Escalade. And I'm over there fussing with him about all the money I don't have. And this dude who just popped off of some third world country bicycle. And his clothes were super shabby. And he looked like he had, like, he just looked like, if I had seen him anywhere else, I would have thought he was a bum, like, in a nice way to put it. But is right at the register next to me, and I hear him say, hey, I wanted to see if that deposit went through. And they're like, yes, Mr. Yan, because, like, they know him by name, I guess, there. And she was like, yes, it went through, the whole thing. He was like, okay, good, good, good. I'll be back tonight to deposit another $1 million. I was like, like I say $1 million, and Lord knows that's what that man said. And she was like, good day. The teller was like, good day, and tell your wife we said hello. And he's like walking off, getting back on his bike. Bruh, you never know. Like, don't underestimate people. You don't know who is who in this world. Same thing within this reference. The person today who's struggling could be the person on top of the world. The person today who may look like they ain't got it all could be somebody else. And just plain and simple, okay? Let me tell you something about old money, all right? New money is what the rappers be doing, running around out on fancy cars and big watches and bling blings. Old money, you never know they come from money. You want to know why? Because half of them running around, you would never, like, if you was to put old money in a lineup with new money, you'd be pointing to all the wrong niggas. Why? Because people who don't got it is so gung-ho and making somebody think they got it, they go so above and over. Those people who got it, they sit back and they chill, you know what I mean? Don't even got on name brand. Won't catch a Gucci belt on their ass because that's just something they're used to. So never judge a book by its cover. Get in the comment section down below and let me know what were your two cents. This song was full of killer lines. What portion of it resonated the most with you? Also, give me more to check out by MGK. You already know. Go ahead and give this video a thumbs up. Subscribe and turn on notifications so that you don't miss out. Until next time, guys. Peace out. I'm out of here.